Well, some of the rally caps are out on the ice. The Kings trying to rally here, trying to get back in, but look at the job done on Wayne Gretzky.
Well, they try to have ticket in on him as much as possible this evening, but that doesn't always happen. Sometimes it's just the line changes, and they have different people on different lines that will pick up Gretzky. In this case, you know, it was Graves. This was a very controversial call. The ice has just been littered with everything that you can think of. Andy Van Hellem says that Gretz, maybe, well, you took a dive in my eyes. This has stopped the game.
The reaction from Wayne Gretzky. The picture again, worth so many words. And again tonight it's been that bad. Bill Ranford, after the team trailed 3-1, said, well, we wonder. But the Oilers recover with 4 unanswered goals in the second period. 37 shots that Ranford has faced tonight. 3 of them in the first period got by him, 2 in the span of 11 seconds, the one by Robinson and then by Ellick, as the Kings set a new team record. Fastest 2 goals in their playoff history. That was all they were to get to this stage, and we still have 5 minutes and 34 seconds left in the third period. This copyrighted telecast is presented by the authority of Sports Channel America and is intended for the private, non-commercial use of our audience. Any publication, reproduction, retransmission, or other use of the pictures, descriptions, and accounts of this event without the express written consent of Sports Channel America is prohibited. 5 minutes, 34 seconds remaining in the third period. The debris has been removed. A lot of those rally caps hurled on the ice. Andy Van Hellemann not endearing himself to this crowd tonight. One of the veteran referees, regarded as one of the best in the league. Several times he has upset the crowd by non-calls. Not that the penalties or lack of whatever should determine the outcome of the game. Let the boys play, and Andy handles the game with that thought in mind. Ranford out to play the puck. Got bumped by Sandstrom. Now the Oilers come out, led by Messier. One-on-one with Duchesne. Coming up to join the play is Curry, and Messier handling the puck, pulls it away from Duchesne. Centers Curry with a shot. Gossel on the save. Boy, Messier put it right on Curry's tape again, and Gosselin had it all figured out.
Well, that was a tough save for any goalie, but Gosselin played that exceptionally well.
Again, we think back to our surprise when Ron Scott was named to start the game tonight. It wasn't until just before game time that word leaked out. Over the blue line with it is McTavish, and he shot one wide.
Edmonton is very comfortable and just going into a little, well, they're just protecting that lead. They don't like anything at the offensive blue line. They're just dumping it in, playing the forechecking game, keeping the puck in front of them. Get the puck out of their zone, get it in the zone, running the clock in their favor.
Here's Tinelli trying to break in for the Kings. Taken down, back of the net. Crowder forechecking here, puts it out in front, but through Halkidas, who would come in to join the play.
LA has had to shorten their bench now. They've got to go to their top 6 forwards. They've got to get Gretzky out there as much as possible.
A year ago, after eliminating the Edmonton Oilers in 6 games, the Los Angeles Kings went on to defeat the 7 games, excuse me, and then went on to lose in 4 consecutive games to the Calgary Flames. So a year ago, they eliminate the defending Stanley Cup champs and lose in 4. We're following the same kind of script here as Edmonton is about to take a 3-0 lead in games.
They did not shadow Gretzky as tough last year as they're doing this year, Jigs, and it shows.
That has certainly been one of the keys. The other, as we've said before, the inspired play of the youngsters. And there's Anderson shooting one wide. Greg off the right point. His shot's wide of the net. A lot of credit has to go to Glenn Sather. We talk about the job John Muckler and the coaching staff has done. There's Greg with a shot from the point that was blocked, and now Anderson centers to Messier in deep. Ed Gosselin down, centers it out in front. Randy Gregg fires, and it's blocked in front of the net. Now a backhander from Messier is covered by Gosselin, and there is no further play. 3 minutes and 8 seconds remaining in the third period. Just to finish the thought on Glenn Sather, recognizing the fact that his team needed some speed, some more speed, he went out and made some deals, and the team has responded and reacted, and here's the opportunity a moment ago.
Well, this is quite a flurry for Edmonton. You watch this guy down deep, Craig Simpson. He works very well in the lower part of the slot. He took a heavy hit there by Halkidas, but now he'll get a shot right from the point And I believe it was Randy Gray took a shot there, and he caught that shot. And it was a tough shift for Craig Simpson. He makes one last effort. He's falling down, trying to get to a backhand. But that's sort of his office down there. Sometimes, Jigs, I think he's got to be wearing a pack jacket.
He should be. You think in this game, the first save that the starting goaltender, Ron Scott, made didn't come until the 48-second mark of the second period. And by the 12-13 mark of the period, he was out of the game and given up four goals. And in comes the Goose, as they call him. Well, there was a time this season when everybody here associated with the Kings thought the Goose had been cooked. He'd been sent to New Haven of the American Hockey League. They didn't expect him back. They brought Rob Stauber in. They had Ron Scott playing so well, along with Kelly Rudy, as his recovery period continued. And as Rudy got stronger, he was the starter. He's nowhere to be found tonight. Rib injury, reportedly. Given up 12 goals. The other goal by the Oilers in the first two games. Into an empty net. This is Casper into the Edmonton zone. Centers one for Duchesne, trying to work through traffic. Spun it across the front of the net. It comes back to Robinson. Into Gretzky. Wayne Gretzky gets rubbed off the puck. Randy Gregg was right on him. And the Oilers have cleared it into center ice. Brought back in again by Duchesne. 2.5 minutes to play. Third period at the Great Western Forum. This is Robinson up to Casper. Casper over the line, set up Sandstrom for a shot that was blocked, and the rebound is cleared out. I mentioned earlier how Sandstrom bumps people. Just as Lamb came out of the player change, Sandstrom met him with the stick. A little irritation. Now Sandstrom into forecheck, trying to finish his check on Steve Smith. The Kings set up in the center ice zone. Here's McSorley.
2 minutes left, Jigs, down by two. He got to start thinking about pulling the goalkeeper. Well, that clock is just going to get right away from you. Remember the game two when Tommy Webster, L.A. coach, pulled a goalkeeper in a 4-1 game.
Mm-hmm.
But anyway, that's what you have to do. Shorten your bench. You have to go for it. It's a situation where Edmonton has had a funny game, Jigs. First period, they were non-existent. Second period, they had some breaks, and it was more L.A. not handling the situation well. In this period, they haven't played their normal up-tempo skating game, but they played a very intelligent game, as I said, by getting the puck out, getting it in, picking up Gretzky. They put a defensive forward in each line to keep him under wraps. So they've switched gears quite well in this game.
Tommy Webster and the Kings have called their 32nd timeout. We'll see if they leave Gosselin on the ice. This gives the Oilers a chance to talk it over as well. So with the score, the Edmonton Oilers 5, the Los Angeles Kings 3, we'll see if the Kings can get themselves back into this game.
Lincoln Mercury Dealers are celebrating Motor Trend's 1990 Car of the Year Award with some award-winning values of their own.
You'll save with $1,500 customer cash on Mercury Cougar direct from Lincoln Mercury. Up to $1,000 customer cash on Mercury Sable and Topaz. And $750 customer cash on the full-size Mercury Grand Marquis. Or ask about special financing or red carpet lease rates.
It's all going on right now. See your nearby Lincoln Mercury dealer today.
These were the signs that were handed out to the fans tonight as they arrived at the Great Western Forum. They haven't worked. Neither of the rally hats or track staff. That's, no, that isn't John Shannon. Although it looks a lot like John. He could be a future television executive. He's every big pussy.
Got that chin in that.
Talks to himself as well.
I'm not saying anything, Jigs. I'm in the doghouse the way it is. I'm passing.
Here comes Gosselin. Los Angeles will go with the extra attacker. 4-6 men into the Edmonton zone. The Oilers up with the puck. Can't clear it out. McSorley dumps it in deep. Krushelnicki goes to the corner for it. Trying to get it to Gretzky back of the net. Wayne Gretzky to McSorley, and his shot is blocked. And the puck bounces out towards center ice. Duchesne back. He lost it. Hakanen dumps it in. McSorley chases it. So does Curry. And Marty McSorley is able to put it on Krushelnicki's stick. He got it right back from Robinson, then couldn't handle it. Curry in forechecking for Edmonton. This is McSorley with a cross-ice pass. Thomas Sandstrom over the Edmonton line with a shot off the pads of Frandtfort. Kevin Lowe bangs one off the boards. It's held in by Sandstrom. Gets tied up here with Curry. The puck back. Duchesne centers one. Deflected. Locked down. Gretzky shoots. He scores!
Jakes, they still have some time. Minute 9 left. That goalie getting out there, that just freed up Gretzky enough, and he didn't waste any time in that situation. He's sort of in his office. He's always around that goal line when there's little traffic down there, and he tries to position himself, getting out of sight and out of mind. Again, that puck came to him. Billy Radford had no chance. Now, you might want to say, why didn't you pick him up now? Well, you want to say, geez, they've got the extra guy. What do? We just got to sort of break our checking assignments and just play it in a normal situation. Maybe they just say, I'll play Gretzky in a one-for-one and let everybody else react to the puck.
Mario Gosselin is back in the nets. Had a look at John Muckler. Prior to that, Wayne Gretzky. The time situation that Herb pointed to, 1 minute and 9 seconds left in the third period. And the lead is only one goal. With the extra man on the ice, Wayne Gretzky scores at 18:51. Duchesne and Sandstrom get the assists.
Follow me, Jake. You're shadowing Gretzky all night long, and he had not had a shot, okay, for a couple of periods. So I'm saying when the goalie's out, I would still put somebody on Gretzky, and my other four people will take care of the other five, because Gretzky is still the guy you got to hold in check. They elected to go just a normal situation, 5 against 6, react to whatever variable there was. That freed up Gretzky.
Now the Kings get control of the puck following the draw. McSorley with a pass to Kasper. Leads across ice. There's Gretzky. Robitaille goes to the front of the net. Gosselin comes to the bench. Gretzky fakes, fakes, holds it, shoots. It's blocked in front. McSorley can't get it loose, and here's Anderson. The Kings with 6 attackers. They break up the Edmonton rush at center ice. Gretzky feeding it up to Steve Duchesne. Can't play it through Gregg. Now Gretzky gets through it again at center and dumps it in. Charlie Huddy has given it to Randy Gregg. Took some time, worked it to center ice. Duchesne with a pass to Kasper. They step over the line. Kasper plays it around the boards. Huddy tips it. It goes right to Gretzky, and then he gets checked by Huddy. Gretzky strips the puck away, flips it in front. Over the stick of Kasper. Sandstrom had been there as well, and Simpson dumps it out for Edmonton.
Jake's exactly what I'm talking about. I don't understand Edmonton here. They still got to keep somebody on Gretzky. They've totally let him go, and look at the opportunities that are coming about right now.
Now 10 seconds left as McSorley dumps the puck in right to Ranford. He drops it off. 6 seconds as you see the time tick down. Import is Duchesne. Can they get another shot? No, they'll be beaten 5-4 by the Edmonton Oilers, and Bill Ranford, after a shaky first period by his team in front of them, holds on. He kept them in and now forces Los Angeles to the brink. And Sandstrom is being restrained here. As you look at Ranford, the officials are all over Sandstrom, who has gone to the Edmonton bench for whatever reason. Here's the confrontation. John Muckler exchanging some words with Thomas Sandstrom. I mentioned before how Sandstrom was starting to get under the skin of some of the Edmonton players. You see Wayne Gretzky getting involved in this. He is headed off the ice. Somebody just fired their stick into the Edmonton bench. Well, with the Los Angeles Kings on the brink here of elimination, they are not a happy group. Lost the cool right at the end of the game.
Well, Jiggs, I look at this game. Edmonton was bad, and they were lucky, and they were smart. This was not the good, bad, and ugly. They were the bad, lucky, and smart. There were no shows that first period. They were lucky the second, and they played an intelligent third period.
And the final score at the Great Western Forum, the Edmonton Oilers 5, the Los Angeles Kings 4, as we pause now for a regional break. Sports Channel's coverage of the Stanley Cup playoffs will continue following these messages.
Dreading a typical night on television? Call this number instead.
Who's on the line?
And you can enter the Twilight Zone. On video cassette only through the CBS Video Library. Examine your first cassette risk-free for 10 days. See why this remarkable series earned 3 Emmy Awards. Witness masterful performances by some of America's favorite stars, like Jack Klugman.
How come you're 10 years old again?
And rediscover the genius of Twilight Zone's creator, Rod Serling.
Just a prolonged nightmare.
in which fear, loneliness, and the unexplainable walk hand in hand through the shadows.
Now, it can be yours to enter whenever you like. Your first video cassette of four classic episodes is only $4.95. Call now to order The Twilight Zone on video cassette, only from the CBS Video Library. Credit card orders only, unless you prefer another typical night on television.
The WBL is back. Sports Channel America presents exclusive national coverage of this dynamite hoops league that features a 6'5" height limit that makes it faster and more exciting. The WBL is back on Sports Channel America.
Sports Channel America cranks up the power this summer with nitro-breathing piston power action. See eight top NASCAR races in the Grand National Championship. The series takes off April 28th with the Busch Grand National 200, only on the Sports Channel America Network.
This is a golfer. He'll play anywhere. Golf Digest magazine helps his game anywhere he plays with instructional articles from top pros. So wherever you play, play better with Golf Digest.
Get a full year of Golf Digest for $19.77. Call 800-841-0300 now and get a free half-hour instructional video with your paid subscription. Call 800-841-0300 now.
The Edmonton Oilers defeat the Los Angeles Kings 5-4 at the Great Western Forum after LA had led 3-1 at the end of the first. Thomas Sandstrom is to get his fifth playoff goal at the 106 mark. Greg Simpson comes back to tie it for Edmonton at 15:26. And then an explosion for the Kings. Two goals in 11 seconds. Larry Robinson at 19:20. Todd Ehrlich with his third of the playoffs at 19:31. And the Kings went to the dressing room leading by a score of 3-1 and outshot Edmonton 13-1. But the Oilers respond with four goals in the second period. Simpson with his second from Curry and Lamb at 5:34. Then Klima scores unassisted at the 6:50 mark. Ruotsalainen from back of the net gets his second at the 12:13 mark. The game tied, now in the hands of the Oilers, and Graves gives them a two-goal lead. His first in the playoffs from Messier at 15:33. Even though Edmonton were dominated by the Kings as far as shots on goal in that second period. And the only goal in the third period, Wayne Gretzky. Kings with the extra man on, the goaltender on the bench. Gretzky from Duchesne and Sandstrom at 18:51. That's as close as the Kings could get. Total shots on goal, again in the third period, the Kings outshooting them 10-7 and 39-18 on the night. But it's the Edmonton Oilers prevailing, coming from behind to take the lead and hold on for a 5-4 win. Two goals tonight scored by Craig Simpson. One on a power play in the first period. Was the only shot on goal for the Oilers in the period, and it tied the game at 15:26. And then an inspired Edmonton team coming out for the second period. This is where they get themselves back into the game at the 5:34 mark. That pass from Curry to Simpson, one times it, is seventh of the playoffs. Edmonton trailed by one, and from there, they go on to win it 5-4. And there's the man who scored two goals tonight, Craig Simpson, down in our studios. Congratulations, first of all. I don't imagine for one moment that whatever John Muckler said going to the second period was brand new to you. It certainly wasn't anything you hadn't heard before, right, Craig?
Well, there wasn't much need to be said. We knew we didn't come out and take the game to them. I think we waited a little bit, and they really took the whole period to us. They forechecked very aggressively. We were a little scrambly, and we didn't come out ready to play. So I just think we regrouped. We didn't say too much and just knew we had to come out with a lot better effort in the second period.
We noticed some chippiness, too, creeping in, especially in the third period.
Yeah, I think, they're frustrated, and the way the game was, it was a seesaw battle. You know, they started out all guns blaring and got the lead, and then we stormed back, and I think it frustrated them a little bit. And there's a lot of little cheap shots behind the play that, don't really need to be there.
Craig, the play, I think, that maybe turned it around was that little 2-1 that you and Yeri Curry had. And Yeri made a great move along the boards, and the defenseman didn't elect to let the goalkeeper take care, and he slid over, and he gave you a great opportunity. You just one-timed it. And from there, it just sort of picked up your game totally. You know, it just got you going again.
I think so. I think that got us a little bit of a spark. Yeri made a great play to get by Duchesne there, as you saw. And I was thinking about going to the net, and then, as you said, the defenseman played him, so I just stopped up high in the slot, and Yeri made a perfect pass. And from there, I think the team got a little bit of life. Peter Klima got a great goal, and then you saw us start to take the game over a little bit.
We're seeing a lot of balance, a lot better balance, I think, in the lines and the overall play than the Oilers showed a lot of people down the stretch run, especially in March, Craig. What's turned it around?
I think that's been the secret of the success. You look at a line like Adam Graves, Martin Jelena, and Joe Murphy. They've been playing just fantastic hockey for us. And I don't think we'd be as successful as we have been without that line going. And Kelly Buckberger's played some super hockey for us. And I think it's just been a fact of the last series against Winnipeg, everybody sort of got their confidence. Everybody got a chance to play, realized that they can contribute to this team. And with that, I think it's brought them a lot of life.
And I have to credit the scouting staff, too. They had a pretty good book on the Los Angeles Kings coming into this series. And now, with the 5-4 win tonight, the Oilers are up 3-0. Our thanks to Craig Simpson and our congratulations on a 2-goal performance. Right at the end of the game, while the Oilers were about to celebrate a victory, they take a look at the clock and know that they have this one in the vault at 5-4. Some ugliness. I mentioned the Thomas Sandstrom had been involved, as John Munkler is being congratulated by Ted Green and the staff on the bench. Munk says, well, wait a minute, what's going on? Turns around, and who should be coming over to greet him but number 7 for the Kings, Thomas Sandstrom. Oh, he takes a shot at the trainer, I guess, is where the stick came in there. There was a major penalty handed out, a major penalty for spearing, and a game misconduct at the 20-minute mark of the third period to Thomas Sandstrom. And the conversation continued very deeply. Really the story tonight, not only the goaltending of Brantford, but the 2 goals from Craig Simpson, and the Oilers win it 5-4.
1989, the year the Sea of Red became the Sea of Champions. Now get Sea of Champions, the official Stanley Cup home video. Follow the road to the Cup. See the record breakers and the intense division matchup. Watch Montreal battle to the finals, only to see Calgary capture its first Stanley Cup. Sea of Champions is just $23.50. Call now at 1-800-521-8500 or write to Sea of Champions, Box 68618, Indianapolis, Indiana, 46268.
Sports Channel America and USA Today want to put you in the Stanley Cup Finals. We're giving away round-trip coach airfare for 2, 4-day, 3-night hotel accommodations, and tickets to the first 2 games of the Stanley Cup Finals. Call to order USA Today and be entered automatically, or send your name, address, and daytime phone number on a postcard to the address on the screen. Postcards must be received by May 3rd, and you must be at least 18 years old to enter. Win a trip to one of these great cities in the USA Today Sports Channel America Stanley Cup Finals giveaway.
Color, excitement, thrill, heat on ice, the world of NHL merchandise. Real hockey fans show their team spirit with official NHL products.
Oh, and now it's snapped on the air by Vernon. Here's Carbonell going to the goal. Score! Gretzky, across the line, left side, he shoots, he scores!
Look for official NHL merchandise at fine stores near you.
Soccer fever is gripping America as it prepares for its first World Cup appearance in 40 years. Sports Channel America presents exclusive coverage of key games leading up to this worldwide showdown in Italy. Catch World Cup fever only on the Sports Channel America network. Monday, it's the pivotal third game of a Wales Division Finals. The series between the Rangers and the Caps shifts to Landover. Or see the Bruins invade the Forum for a war with the Canadiens. The Stanley Cup playoffs on Sports Channel America, Monday.
Once again, the final score, the Edmonton Oilers 5, the Los Angeles Kings 4. Tomorrow, the Stanley Cup playoffs continue with Wales Conference Division Final excitement. Catch Game 3 as the Boston Bruins battle the Montreal Canadiens. Plus, the New York Rangers take the ice against the Washington Capitals. It's a full night of playoff action tomorrow at 7:30 Eastern, live on Sports Channel America. I'm Jakes McDonald for Herb Brooks saying so long until next time. You've been watching Sports Channel America's coverage of the Stanley Cup playoffs.
Welcome back to our Sports Channel America studios in New York. I'm Bob Papa. We hope you enjoyed tonight's Stanley Cup playoff action. The Edmonton Oilers with a commanding 3-0 lead over the Los Angeles Kings. And St. Louis leads Chicago now in the Norris Division Finals, 2-1 by virtue of their thrilling 5-4 victory. Well, our action continues here on Sports Channel America Monday evening with Wales Conference action. First, the Patrick Division Finals. The Rangers and Capitals tied at 1-1. Game number 3 from the Cap Center in Landover, Maryland at 7:30 Eastern time, and the Adams Division Finals as well. We'll take you to the Forum in Montreal. Boston leads the Canadiens 2-0 as they get set for game number 3 Monday evening, 7:30 Eastern time. Check your local listings. Well, that wraps it up from our New York studios. For our entire crew, I'm Bob Papa. You've been watching the Stanley Cup playoffs exclusively on Sports Channel America.
This has been a presentation of Sports Channel America.
John Patrick is a professional gambler. His full-length in-depth videos have helped thousands of casino players win at craps, blackjack, roulette, video poker. These easy-to-follow videos cover everything from the basic fundamentals and strategy for the novice to sophisticated money management and hedging techniques for the advanced player. Now, John Patrick introduces football and horse race handicapping, plus the first in a brand new series, the lottery video. Patrick believes that expert knowledge, discipline, and strict money management are the keys to success. He offers no miracle systems, no instant riches, just sensible, practical advice on how you can reduce the house edge and become a more consistent winner. Each tape is $39.95, three for $99. To order, call toll-free 1-800-283-4030. Visa, MasterCard, American Express accepted. Call now, 1-800-283-4030.
You're watching Sports Channel. And all the latest sports news is right here on your television set.
We'll be right back.
This is Sports Channel.
John Patrick is a professional gambler. His full-length in-depth videos have helped thousands of casino players win at craps, blackjack, roulette, video poker. These easy-to-follow videos cover everything from the basic fundamentals and strategy for the novice to sophisticated money management and hedging techniques for the advanced player. Now, John Patrick introduces football and horse race handicapping, plus the first in a brand new series, the lottery video. Patrick believes that expert knowledge, discipline, and strict money management are the keys to success. He offers no miracle systems, no instant riches, just sensible, practical advice on how you can reduce the house edge and become a more consistent winner. Each tape is $39.95, three for $99. To order, call toll-free, 1-800-283-4030. Visa, MasterCard, American Express accepted. Call now, 1-800-283-4030. Thank you.
This is Sports Channel. This is Sports Channel.
If you're an investor who's too busy during the day to attend to your financial transactions, try Charles Schwab's convenient 24-hour service. Listen now, as Paul D'Souza, supervising broker on the midnight shift to Charles Schwab, explains.
Our customers represent a full spectrum of individuals, and many of them simply don't have the time during the day to attend to their financial transactions. And they find it very convenient to call Charles Schwab at all hours of the day or night. We're there. They call us from New York when they get up in the morning. They call us from Honolulu as they're on their way to bed at night. We're there all the time. And we'll get your business done even though it's the middle of the night. Your order will be there for the next day's market. No problem, no hassle.
For free information about Schwab services, call toll-free 800-228-6260. That's 800-228-6260. Call Schwab now. Member SIPC. You're watching Sports Channel.
I love tennis. I'm crazy about it. I live, eat, and breathe tennis. If I'm not playing tennis, I'm watching. And if I'm not watching tennis, I'm reading Tennis Magazine. Tennis Magazine serves up everything I want to know about tennis, and I want to know everything. Each month, Tennis Magazine gives me articles on instruction, equipment, resorts, fashion, even the truly outstanding personalities of tennis today. Maybe I should be in there. Anyway, if you love tennis, you'll love Tennis Magazine.
Subscribe now. Get 12 issues of Tennis Magazine for only $9.97. Just call 800-228-5400. 12 issues of Tennis Magazine, only $9.97. Call now. We'll throw in a free professional instruction booklet to help make you better faster. So call 800-228-5400. I'll tell you this, anyone who loves tennis is going to love Tennis Magazine. Subscribe now. That's 800-228-5400. This is Sports Channel, and all the latest sports news is right here on your television set. We'll be right back.
This is how a heart attack can kill you. Your arteries start out smooth on the inside. Cholesterol comes from many of the foods you eat. Too much in your blood can slowly line your arteries, narrowing them. And because the cholesterol buildup is rough, your blood is fooled into clotting, blocking the narrowed artery that feeds your heart, choking off its oxygen. And then you die. You can help prevent heart disease. We can tell you how. Call your American Heart Association.
You're watching Sports Channel. You're tuned to Sports Channel, and all the latest sports news is right here on your television set.
If you're a golfer, you know what I'm talking about. Teeing up with my regular foursome at the club, right? The first hole, 260 yards, straight down the middle, played it a million times. The three wood feels great, everything great. Then it happens. I feel all those eyes on me. I get cold stiff. I start to think. Club back straight, follow through, head down. I get so I could barely swing.
First hole anxiety. Every golfer knows it. The kind of thing you'll learn to handle if you read Golf Digest. Every month, Golf Digest comes filled with articles on instruction, equipment, resorts, even psychology. Whether you golf a little or a lot, Golf Digest builds your game and your confidence.
Subscribe now. 12 issues, only $19.77. Just call 1-800-521-1100. Call now. We'll throw in 10 instant golf lessons, a half-hour instructional video with your paid subscription. Call now, 1-800-521-1100. Get Golf Digest now.
We'll be right back.
You're tuned to Sports Channel.
Time is a precious commodity. The busier you are, the more you treasure it. That's why it makes good business sense for you to start 1990 with a subscription to the Wall Street Journal. With the Journal's time-saving format, you'll get the latest news on what's happening in the economy and how it affects you, your company, and your career. You'll learn about new developments in technology, marketing, small business, and the law. And you'll appreciate the Journal's clear financial tables and charts you can refer to at a glance. The Wall Street Journal helps you find all the business news you need in less time. So subscribe now, and with your paid subscription, you'll also receive a valuable 120-page guide to understanding money and markets.
To order the Wall Street Journal, call now toll-free, 800-331-9600. You'll get 13 weeks of the journal and the 120-page guide, all for only $34. Today's Wall Street Journal, faster, tougher, smarter. Call 800-331-9600. Call now, 800-331-9600.
Thank you.
This is Sports Channel.